Nina Turner, obviously of the Bernie Sanders campaign. Welcome. Good to see you. Hillary Rosen, CNN contributor. Good to have you as well. I am assuming that you are taking the Biden side of the debate because...
I am. I'm endorsing Joe Biden today. It's new for me. I've been neutral in this primary, but, you know, I've been holding out hope for a woman president since 2008. That's not happening. But I'm really comfortable with Joe Biden. I trust him. I've known him for many years. I think he will be a great president, and I'm totally happy to endorse him today.
Thank you for announcing on the show. It is good to have it be transparent. I'm going to put up the lists of problems for both of your people, and we will go point for point. I do not care what either of you has to say about the other campaign. Justify your own. That's what tonight's about. Hillary, I'll start with you.
Okay.
First point on Biden, past prime, nice guy. As Meghan McCain said on The View, maybe he is the grief whisperer. He was certainly great to my family when my pop passed, but he's not who he was. We don't see it in the energy, and people lack confidence because of that. How do you respond?
Look, I think we are now facing a prospect where one of, you know, a 70-plus-year-old man is going to be the next president of the United States. And I think that they're all pretty comparable in that regard. I'm confident that, you know, Vice President Biden has vigor. He's shown it on the campaign trail. I think that he is, you know, going to be a solid and stable choice. I'm not worried about that.
The moments where he seems to not remember to be on message, where he seems to not be able to say things the right way.
You know, look, he himself talks about that his old stuttering gets in his way, that he, you know, has a lot of legislative issues that have come up in his campaign and career over the years. Every one of them isn't perfect. The thing about Joe Biden, though, when he gaffes, because we all know he does, you never believe he's lying, right? You just believe moving it across.
We'll get one problem at a time. Yes, he makes mistakes, but there's more than that. We'll get to it in a second, arguably. Nina Turner, your problem.
Chris.
Your man is a socialist. He calls himself a socialist. Doesn't matter if you put Democrat in front of it. It scares people in the country. He refuses to back away from it. And he will be beaten about the head and face with it by the president every day.
Well, it shouldn't scare people. I mean, it's very much in the tradition of President FDR. That is the kind of democratic socialism that he's talking about. And even though FDR didn't necessarily call it that, Sanders talks about the economic. But Chris, it's in the same spirit. It's in the spirit of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who in his letter to the Birmingham jail warned us being the black community, about white moderates. You know that FDR, the 1944 Economic Bill of Rights, what do the American people have a right to? A decent job, decent housing, being able to take care of people when they have, when they're unemployed or old age, disabilities. These are the things that FDR put forward, and
true,
the elites or the corporate Dems of his day came after him, which caused him to say he welcomes their hatred. Senator Bernie Sanders is adding to that, the Green New Deal, Medicare for
that's
all.
That's right. And
so
that's the key that you have to deal with, Nina. He is adding to it. And the way that'll be used as a cudgel is, we have never seen spending like this since the New Deal. His attempts to pay for it are incomplete at best. They scare people, Nina, that he is going to change their economic reality for the worse. In the tens of trillions.
Give me a break. I mean, we don't talk enough about corporate welfare, you know, in this country. We don't talk about how we pay for cuts and subsidies to the wealthiest people, the wealthiest wealthiest companies in this country. But yet when it comes to putting a down payment on Main Street, folks want to raise that issue. Chris, people are suffering in this country. Senator Bernie Sanders is asking them to imagine, to dream a bigger dream. Plus, since we are a hegemon nation, we are a wealthy nation, we're not a poor nation. President Trump gave a $1.6 trillion tax cut to the wealthiest people in this country. That same tax cut could have been used to pay for canceling student debt, which Senator Sanders is pushing for, too. So we have the money. We just need to find the will.
And you need to find the way to explain to people that it won't be on their back. Because that is the fear that you may say it's going to be
really
the rich,
the key,
but they won't
those,
be.
Those cuts are on their backs. The cuts for the
well, but they think they got a tax cut from Trump, and they think you're going to take it back and then some.
They
that's
did
the
not.
That's the challenge. That's the challenge. Now
yeah,
back
I
to
hear you.
You.
But they didn't.
I hear you, but I'm saying that's what you got to deal with. And Hillary, on your side, what you have to deal with is decades of controversial votes that mm-hmm. look bad. And that go along with stories of commitment to social justice and moments in his past that may not be accurate. And each one will be pointed out by the president. You did the crime bill. Obama was thinking about it when he was like 11 or whatever the president said today, that Obama was thinking about the crime bill, too. I know it's BS, but it's how Biden deals with it. You said you were arrested when you were with Mandela. I don't think so. You say that you were trained to be a protester and suffered. We don't think so. How do you deal with the record of votes and of stories that don't hold up?
You know, Nina referenced Dr. Martin Luther King before, saying that he said from the Birmingham jail that we should be concerned about white moderates. That's actually not what Martin Luther King said. What he said is
he
we should be worried
that.
About the
about
silence
Dr. Martin
of
Luther
white
King
moderates.
Jr. Are you kidding me?
Nina? Wait,
no, she's making a language point.
What he said was we should worry about the silence of white moderates. And what we have in Joe Biden is a man who is not silent. He has a long record. And many, many votes that in today's world feel like the wrong thing were the wrong thing. And he has discussed that over and over again, as Bernie Sanders did on the gun votes and other things. So we can be talking about votes from 20 years ago, or we can be talking about people's values and
right.
who they trust.
Last quick
and
point.
That's what Joe Biden's going to be talking
Last
about.
Last quick point to you, Nina.
With the Reverend Chris, what Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was talking about, he said it is the point that the white moderate wants things to be comfortable, and instead of focusing in on that, the bigger threat is not necessarily the white KKK member, but more the white moderate that is more comfortable
you
with keeping
what?
Things
don't,
the same
don't
or pretending
use,
like there
don't
is no tension.
Don't use Martin Luther King against
then,
Joe
then
Biden.
To deal.
You don't
first
have
of all,
that.
Nobody,
you
first
don't
of all,
have that standing.
First of all,
I'm
Hillary,
sorry. You
don't. Don't tell me what kind of standing
you,
I have
you,
as a black woman in America. How dare you?
You have a
first
lot
of all,
standing as a black woman in America. You don't
have
the standing
you need
to attack Joe Biden using Martin Luther King's words.
I didn't attack anybody. You're taking it that way. Listen, don't dip into what I have to say about the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. How dare you,
hold
as
no,
a
no,
white
no.
woman,
right,
sit up here
that.
And try to tell me
that
no,
is not
no,
what
try
I said.
To tell me
don't
what,
you do
I'm,
that.
What
Nina,
I'm supposed
Hillary,
to feel and what I'm doing right
I'm
now.
I'm out of time on this.
That's
but look,
Chris,
listen.
I didn't jump in on her,
Nina,
though. Well, and then she wants to jump in on me.
Okay,
and
first
me
of all, it's not nobody's jumping in on anybody. You guys are in the same party. This is what you guys have to figure out. You're in the same party. And let me tell you, you better keep that same energy when you're up against Trump that you have against each other, because he is bigger and badder than I think you guys are ready for. But let's agree on this about Dr. King. Only light can drive out darkness. Only love can drive out hate. That is the challenge for
well,
the Democrats to show that that's what you represent
Chris.
Against this president. I wish you both good luck going forward.
Amen.
You are always welcome here to make the case to my audience. Nina Turner, be well.
Thank you.
Hillary
Take
Rosen,
care.
Thank you for the announcement.
Take care, Nina.
Be well.